right, Adnan, thanks very much. We have a sellout crowd gathering today here at the Coliseum in Morgantown, West Virginia. It is our Saturday showcase presented by 5-Hour Energy. And after a great start to the Saturday with Michigan going down in Madison, number 7 Kansas on the road to take on the Mountaineers of West Virginia. Big 12 standings. Texas Tech lost a few nights ago. So Kansas back tied atop the Big 12 standings. West Virginia still looking for its first conference win. Hi, everybody. Dave Fleming alongside Fran Fraschilla. Chris Button is with us as well. For the last many years, Fran, this has been the biggest game in Big 12 play. This year, a little different on paper because the Mountaineers have struggled so much.
And in those 5 losses in conference, they've actually had a chance to win 4 of those games. So they can do it here. Kansas has struggled at times in the 6 meetings here. They're only 2-4. That tells you something.
This has been a difficult place for Bill Self's team to play. Dedrick Lawson, meanwhile, Fran, has been a heck of a player for the Jayhawks.
No question. Sporting News midseason All-American team. 47 double-doubles to go along with what's been. He's the focal point of the Kansas offense, inside and out.
So here we go from Morgantown, where despite the 0-5 conference record, 5-game losing streak, this is a very proud program, and people here are wondering what is going on. Despite all that, sellout crowd, it is going to be loud. And Fran just said it, this has been a difficult place for the Jayhawks to play. Lawson will get an immediate touch inside. Grimes traveled. That's a turnover for Kansas.
Dedrick Lawson will get a lot of attention inside today. And you saw Quentin Grimes travel. He's been more aggressive lately early in games. That's a good sign for Kansas.
A young player with a lot of talent, a lot of expectation level, who has not necessarily played consistently up to that level. How about the freshman Gordon going to the basket, but his shot was rejected by Lawson. And now in the open court, LeGerald Vick with a foul.
That's too easy. West Virginia did not turn the ball over on the offensive end. They got a good look. Off the missed shot, they did not get back in transition, and that's something you can't do if you want to stay in this game with Kansas.
Well, the smile for LeGerald Vick, that is a good sign for the Jayhawks. When he feels good, feels confident, starts a game off quickly, it's usually a good sign for them.
Absolutely. Last 2 games, he has been on fire, Dave.
He's already given the shush sign to the West Virginia fans. We're not even a minute in. And some pressure from the Jayhawks. You think of West Virginia, Kansas trying to take it to the Mountaineers. That was not a good pass.
That's part of the problem right there.
It has frustrated their head coach, has it not?
More so than I can ever remember, honestly. We were in Fort Worth the other day. That game wasn't close, and you know, to me, there's an element missing that goes beyond talent. It's toughness and leadership.
That's a good play on the ball by Jermaine Haley out of the open with the finish.
Well, the JUCO transfer, you can tell he's got the coach's trust.
Devon Dotson so fast with the ball, but couldn't finish.
He doesn't miss that left-handed layup too often.
Here's Haley.
You know, it's a simple game, Dave. You got to get more shots in your opponent, and they got to be better shots. That is an example right there of West Virginia not giving themselves to get more shots, the turnovers. They're turning the ball over in Big 12 play almost once every 4 times down the floor. And that is a bad recipe for winning games.
Well, let's say hi for the first time here this afternoon to Chris Button. Chris?
Well, I'm talking with Bob Huggins this morning. He doesn't know the buttons to push to get this team going. You were talking, Fran, about that lack of leadership, and he doesn't know one person to specifically talk to. They're coming off that worst loss against TCU, but they did have one of their best practices on Thursday.
And they are, at least for now, starting this game without Beetle Bolden, who we understand has a little bit of an illness issue.
A we will see if he can get it again. He is now on the bench with his team. He was going through warm-ups, then he sort of disappeared, was scratched from the initial starting lineup we saw. He's one of their most talented players. It would be important for him to get on the court for West Virginia. Nice cut from Harlow. And a good pass that time.
Absolutely. And there's a perfect example. When you run the offense without turning it over and you execute, you're going to get opportunities to score. It's pretty simple.
Dotson, I think he traveled. Yes, he did. Well, Bill Self still feels like this team, so young at times, inexperienced at times, has a lot of upside, still trying to figure out what kind of team they are. And, of course, they've lost their primary big man. They're waiting to see if Silvio DeSosa can come back and play. There's still some question marks for this Kansas team.
Yeah, but they're getting better and better, and they certainly know how to play small. And keep in mind, nobody wins more games on the road in the major conferences since 2004 than Bill Self. Kansas wins 70% of their road games.
Culver's in the game. Derek Culver, the freshman big man who has really played well in Big 12 play after sitting out the first 10 games. Shot clock winding down. Haley's got to launch one. He does, but he hit nothing. Air ball, that's a turnover.
Yeah, and Jermaine Haley was not, he did not have a shot clock in his head because he had that ball with enough time to make a play before he had to jack up that contested shot.
Here's Garrett on the left wing, coming off his best offensive game. I think you have to qualify that. He's had a lot of good defensive games. Vic knocks down the jumper.
Oh, he was outstanding. He was outstanding the other night, no question about it. 20 points. He's one of the best defensive players, not in the Big 12, but in the country.
Well, you were there at Fog Allen for that terrific game, Kansas-Texas. The start of this Saturday almost feels to me like Big Monday, where Syracuse goes to Cameron, knocks off Duke. It's a home game for Wisconsin, but a big upset against Michigan. Harler with the left hand, and the big man found him.
Yep. And I'll say this early. Kansas has not come out ready to play. It's very early, but they're lethargic defensively, and they're giving up too many easy opportunities when West Virginia takes care of the ball. Bill Self will address that quickly in the first timeout, I guarantee you.
Lawson almost threw it away. Here's Garrett right to the rim.
That's great. I mean, if he can continue to give them the offense that he gave them against Texas, he becomes one of the most versatile players in the country. He literally can guard all five positions on the court.
So valuable for this Kansas team, and now the offense starting to blossom. Culver tries to thread one in there. That was dangerous. He did somehow get the ball to Wesley Harris. They're going to call a foul against the Jayhawks, which will send us to our first timeout. At West Virginia, I think it's clear they have come to play. The question for the Jayhawks, who's going to lead the way on offense? It's been a lot of different faces for Kansas here lately. Well, it's early, but a one-point lead for 7th-ranked Kansas. The Jayhawks have had a carousel of leading scores of late, which can be good, and I think there can be some downside to it. In most instances here, I think it's good for the Jayhawks. They got a lot of guys who can step up and score.
Absolutely. When you get into Big 12 play, the idea behind a defense is shut your key guy down. And with Kansas, they don't have one key guy outside of maybe Lawson because he does so many things. And certainly a good situation. I wouldn't even say it's a problem. It's a good situation for Bill Self to be in.
Well, that carousel continues to spin. We don't know our answer yet here this afternoon, who is going to lead the way for the Jayhawks. So Gerald Vick is off to a good start in this one. He and Lawson, the most frequent leading scorers for Kansas. Culver touching the ball. And again, tried that bounce pass to Ahmad cutting toward the baseline. It goes out of bounds.
It was actually a good play because Marcus Garrett is so aware of where the post-up is. He was actually helping, and his man cut back door. They just didn't connect.
That's the third one of those passes that Derek Culver has attempted in this first half. Grimes got rejected by Ahmad at the rim. What a defensive play.
Well, two great plays because I love that Grimes went hard, And I love the finish at the other end on the defensive end.
Wow.
Well, remember, they're playing without West Virginia. No Sagabat Kanate, the all-time leading shot blocker here. And again, I love both plays because Bill Self's going to like the aggressiveness of Grimes, but Issa Ahmad, who's got as big a hands as anybody in this league, put him to good use right there.
Well, I think Kanate, you could make a pretty strong case that he's the best shot blocker in college basketball. So they obviously miss him.
They do. They do. There's no
question. Been out for a while and may be out for a much longer while. They don't know. There's Haley with the handle. Haley's a pretty good ball handler. He almost acts like a point guard at times.
Well, that's exactly. And I think with this team, he's probably their best playmaker because he's a relatively low mistake guy compared to some of West Virginia's other guards, honestly.
Good look for Vic. He was open but missed the three. West Virginia with a one-point lead, 6 minutes in.
See, they can only give themselves a chance to win this game by getting shots up and then doing what they do as well as anybody in the country, and that is pound the offensive glass.
Kansas has been more vulnerable on the defensive boards than a typical Bill Self team. Here's Culver making a move with the left hand. Rebound, Lawson got in there and grabbed it.
Watch his speed.
He got a little out of control, though. He was moving quickly. He committed the offensive foul.
Oh, he's going to come at you, no doubt. One of the fastest players in the country. Let's see at the end of this. Oh, I think he was moving. I think he was moving. That could have easily been called a block. Never felt like he had 2 feet down legally guarded. I thought he slid into the
I agree with you. I think sometimes when the offensive player just looks out of control, that's going to influence the call.
Good point. Absolutely.
Dotson comes out of the game. Ochai Agbaji has made a great first impression. Checks in for the first time. He's playing defense against Harris, and he forced a turnover. So it'll be Kansas ball.
That can't happen when you're trying to put points on the board. I mean, that has been the Achilles heel right there. Now, the average college basketball team turns it over once every six possessions. They're turning it over in conference play almost once every four.
That is a very big difference. And that has been what Bob Huggins has been most focused on with his team. He was all over his kids this morning about just simple passing the ball. Something that sounds pretty simple.
He said, we don't run any plays that don't involve throwing a pass to your teammate. So if you can't pass, we're stuck.
That was his line.
Unless you have James Harden.
Yeah, I don't see Harden out there for the Mountaineers. That was going to be a shot clock violation, and that's what it will be. Culver got the block very emphatically. So no Kanate. They're still protecting the rim.
Well, they got big guys. Gordon, Culver, Ahmad, no question. You see that size on that front line.
Derek Culver's got a chance to be a beast.
Yes, he does. Yeah. They had a little attitude adjustment first semester, and since they've had him back.
One way to put it.
Yeah. He's been a hard worker, and he's got terrific skills inside.
Beetle Bolden, not feeling 100%, that's for sure. Loose ball, he hustles after it. It goes out of bounds off of who? You can tell how much the fans like that call. Jordan McCabe in the game. He helps put a little pressure. The press Virginia is different without.
It's different. Well, they don't have
the two studs.
They don't have press Virginia anymore.
They don't. Agbaji lost it. Kansas turnover.
That might be his first turnover of his career right there.
Culver, that spin move. Good defense by Lawson, and then a foul against Bolden. Tell some back and forth action. If the Mountaineers protect the ball, they're going to be in this game. Well, and I think we're setting the tone here on the college side. Michigan goes down at Wisconsin. West Virginia has clearly come to play here at home against number 7 Kansas. It was our friend Ken Pomeroy who pointed out this morning that today, of the entire season's calendar, the most college hoops games in one day, today.
150, that's amazing. And I'm here with you, which is outstanding. And if I wasn't here with you,
what would you be doing?
I would have carpal tunnel syndrome, I think.
Flipping back and forth.
Yeah, exactly. But we are in a great spot, a great history. And to your point, West Virginia's played really, really hard to start this game.
Kansas won here last year, had lost four in a row in this building before last season, and another Jayhawks turnover. Bolden out in transition. Kansas got back to prevent the layup. Let's go over to Chris.
Bill Self criticizing his team's lack of focus, asking for more energy. He said, guys, we've had some wasted possessions. We're getting uncontested shots, but we're not going up and getting the offensive board.
I would totally agree with that. Chris, you can tell when Bill Self's unhappy, and I don't think he's happy about this start because I don't see the energy.
Well, Moore dribbled it off his leg. That ruined the chance for a fast break layup. And now here is West for the dunk.
Remember, this team that has five losses was good enough to have a 21-point lead at Kansas State. And they feel like they were a play or two away from maybe being 4-1.
Should have beaten Kansas State. Easily could have beaten Texas Tech. Oklahoma State. Kansas just can't take care of the ball. And the script has been flipped a little bit. Nice pass. Culver missed the shot from short range. Got mad about it, but couldn't rip the ball away. Garrett, wide open three. Too strong. Offensive rebound. Abaji missed the putback. Here's KJ Lawson.
Good energy right there by Abaji and Lawson. They stayed with it. Came up with a good putback.
Not pretty, but we heard Chris's and your comments about the energy level, and I think that Bill Self will be pleased with those two young guys. KJ Lawson, maybe it's a stretch to call him young. This is his first year playing with Kansas.
And these guys are human. They know West Virginia is 0-5. I mean, this is a team that is used to winning on the road, as I mentioned.
Kansas hadn't scored in 5 minutes. Shot clock winding down. McCabe, Garrett all over him. And Jordan McCabe just had nowhere to go.
You can't do that. I mean, you can't know that the clock is running down. And just can't do that if you, you want to play better.
Well, tonight, ABC's NBA Saturday Primetime, presented by HyperX Gaming. You saw the shot of James Harden, and it is hard to fully grasp how hot he has been. It's Harden against the Lakers, 8:30 on ESPN.
You know, I love watching the NBA, but honestly, I'm a little bored right now by all these high-scoring games, no defense. Guys aren't practicing as much this time of year.
And I will say, in defense, that's a goaltend. In defense of James Harden, there have been times the last few years where you feel like the whole team is just standing around and watching him. Of course, right now, most of their team is hurt.
That's right.
And they really need it from him. And it's been borderline heroic what he has been able to do these last 15 games or whatever it is.
Well, watching him play is amazing. I think recently.
I get your big picture point.
Well, yeah, you know, watching NBA basketball over the last month, I just think that... I yearn for the days of Lonzo Mourning and Charles Oakley a little bit more.
Well, the freshman Gordon did see Garrett behind him, and he stripped it away. Garrett now quickly into the front court. That was not a great pass.
And the reason it wasn't is because he couldn't throw it over the defender, so he led Dotson, and in leading Dotson, he drew it a little too far. We saw the angle Marcus Garrett had. Watch this. When he steals it, he doesn't think he can throw it over the... Watch, see, Haley? So he leads Dotson just a little too far and just doesn't connect.
Who is a better defensive player in college basketball?
Well, he's the most versatile.
Okay.
Now, if you tell me Xavier Simpson on the ball is a great defender, I'll buy that, the shot blockers. But I think if you needed one guy to be able to guard four or five spots, you'd take Marcus Garrett.
He's a mod. Didn't know where he was. Flew it up onto the backside of the backboard. Here's KJ Lawson for three. Too strong. Arler hustled after it, but Kansas comes away with the ball. Freshman David McCormack in the game. Big body down low. KJ Lawson, another three try. Cormac in there with Culver, and then Garrett steals it away.
That's what he does. And that's just an experience by Culver. Look at that. That's Marcus Garrett at his best. Bill Self has told us many times, I don't feel comfortable if he's not on the floor. And I don't know that you can get a better compliment to a player than to be able to say that.
Versatility, defensive instincts, communication with his teammates. And Marcus Garrett on this end of the floor is without peer right now, I think. Culver's having a real hard time. He's getting looks close to the basket. He's asking for a whistle. He did not get it. That guy is starting to take over the game on the defensive side.
That's exactly right. Only a sophomore. Take a look. Basketball IQ right here. And then the little dump down. Marcus Garrett getting it done. Marcus Garrett is averaging a little under 7 points a game, and certainly coming off the career high 20 against Texas. But offense is not what he is known for. It's this right here, the defensive end. Bill Self calls him one of the best defenders he's ever coached. He's got great instincts for the game. He knows how to guard his man and his teammates' men. And you just take a look right there. Those five guys on the left-hand side, that's not chopped liver now. Pascal will be an NBA player. Horton Tucker eventually will. The other three guys are among the best players at their positions in their leagues. And look at, he can, that's what we talk about. He can guard every spot, Dave.
And that's why I, and not to say that I know, I clearly am not the expert that you are, that our friend Jay Billis is, but I heard Jay on game day this morning talking about Trey Jones, best defender in college basketball. To me, the versatility is a little differentiator with Marcus.
Yeah, I think Xavier Simpson and Trey Jones are great at what they do. They're like shutdown cornerbacks, okay? Yeah. This guy, if you equated it to football, he could play defensive end, he could play linebacker, he could play free safety. You know, and that's why I think, to me, right now, he may be the best all-around defender in college basketball.
Issa Ahmad elevated, couldn't finish. The shots are not going down now for the Mountaineers.
I think the game day crew, which is going to be in Lexington, Kentucky next week, will be talking a lot about Marcus Garrett. Trust me on that one, and rightfully so.
It was fun to see him. If you care about college hoops and guys getting rewarded for working hard, fun to see him have the breakout offensive game on Monday. Here's Grimes, long three.
Well, and it was fun for Bill Self to see him hit three threes in a row. Because he came in shooting about 21%. This game is ripe for West Virginia right now. The way Kansas has come out, but I don't think West Virginia has the ability to give themselves a chance on the offensive end if they're going to turn the ball over. There's a nice move.
Okay, do more of that, and maybe they have a chance.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Because when Kansas does get beat on the road, it's usually a flat performance.
Well, with Garrett not on the floor, things look different. They do. Three on two. Bolden trying for two in a row. He scores!
Not sure what was ailing him, but he seems like he's recovered quickly.
And look who's back at the scorer's table. Marcus Garrett, that's not going to be a long rest. Bolden, that's a jump ball. Arrow favors West Virginia.
Well, watch Beadle now. He's going to create at the rim, left hand, and he's going to come back and transition, go to the right side and finish with his left. Nicely done. And he's going to run the point right now.
The excellent defensive play that gives the Mountaineers this possession. And Kansas has turned the ball over already 11 times.
Think about that. I've said this many times. Kansas gets everybody's best shot, particularly on the road. And more often than not, they answer the bell.
Lawson elevates, in and out. And Cormac helped him get a second chance, and this time he does finish.
I like David McCormick. He is going to be a good, he's going to be a really popular Kansas Jayhawk because he plays so hard. And he's been very patient about his minutes. He knows he's learning the game right now.
a nice luxury when you got a McDonald's All-American who can just ease his way into things.
Exactly. Who's a great teammate and not looking to transfer.
Harris had nowhere to go. Bounced it off of a foot, so it stays West Virginia ball. We've been talking about this gigantic day of sports on our ESPN family. ABC's got Thunder Sixers. That's a good matchup. And, of course, Duke and Virginia at Cameron. That'll be a classic. And then UFC Fight Night, the first big one on ESPN Plus with the undercard and then the main event with the Rockets and Lakers squeezed in between.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. Dillashaw's going down, you know, weight level. And, of course, he's the favorite. But Henry Cejudo, you think about what he's done. The guy's an Olympic gold medalist in wrestling. It'll be fun in Brooklyn.
You can't be a non-tough guy and win an Olympic gold medal in wrestling.
Exactly.
A transition bucket for LeGerald Vick. He's got seven in the first half. Derek Culver is struggling on the offensive side. Talented guy. He's 0 for 5.
And Kansas has gone bigger because West Virginia's got those big guys inside. So Bill Self making a little adjustment right here.
Garrett against Bolden. Lightfoot in the game, switches, and Bolden found a little opening. Not quite James Harden, but that kind of move couldn't knock the shot down. Good quickness by Culver to stay with him, but then he fouled Dedrick Lawson. Timeout here in Morgantown, under four to go. First half, number seven, Kansas, up by three.
NBA. How about Canadian basketball? Let's go.
Canadian basketball, Adnan.
He's got the list. He's got a little cheat sheet. He's going to cue you up on a few different things.
I told Adnan 5 years ago,
yes,
watch out for Toronto. They produce arguably the best basketball in a city in North America. Now, Dallas and Houston, maybe Atlanta, Chicago, but Toronto is loaded with players. They're all over.
And why is that?
Well, there's a good reason. There's the Vince Carter effect, not Steve Nash. They love Steve Nash in Canada. Vince Carter electrified that city. The other thing is the immigration laws in Canada are such that you have this influx of people from the Caribbean and Africa. They're, let's face it, they're big athletic kids. They love the game, Vince Carter. And here's another thing. I've had Canadian coaches tell me that the kids that came over here to play college basketball in the 90s, a generation ago, they're back now coaching these modern-era kids, R.J. Barrett's the world. R.J.'s dad was a very good player at St. John's, and now he helps run Canadian basketball.
Almost a classic Bill Self kind of play. Vic couldn't go up and get the lob pass, though. West is going to launch the three. It's no good. We have not had a made three in this game yet.
That's as much attributed to poor shooting than it is to good defense, because historically this year, both teams do not shoot the three ball well.
Now, those were two ugly shots.
I think we'll have a little more scoring in that Duke-Virginia game.
I think we will, too. And I think we definitely will in that Rockets-Lakers game.
Oh, without a doubt.
The Rockets took 70 threes in a game the other night. Gordon giving a nice boost off the bench. Guess who's unhappy? Andrew Gordon, who started today for the first time in his college career with the dunk that forces a timeout. West Virginia challenging number seven Kansas. All right, back here in Morgantown, where we have a sold-out crowd and a very loud Coliseum. One-point lead for number seven Kansas. This is the play that forced the timeout.
Yep, right there, slow rotation. You double-team the post, you got to get those weak-side guys. Someone's got to protect the rim, and that's why Bill Self called that timeout. Step slow by Kansas so far, to me, on the defensive end.
I killed you there. I talked over your telestration.
Nah, that's not a problem.
Baji. And that one, good hustle by Harler. He threw it off of Garrett. West Virginia basketball under 2 minutes to go in the first half.
Yeah, Again, sloppy play. Ball's loose, and something that we haven't seen very much from the Mountaineers last couple games. Great hustle.
You definitely did not see that in Fort Worth.
No. That was a historically poor performance by Bob Huggins' team. I just don't know if West Virginia can score enough points, because I think Kansas is eventually going to score.
Offensive rebound for West. Had it knocked away, but out of bounds. Or maybe on the offensive glass, they can find some looks from at least closer range.
Remember, this team's playing without Sagabat Kanate.
Their best player.
Their best player. Improving offensively, obviously one of the best defensive players in the country. What a performance last year in this building. And he protected the rim. He had some of the great blocks in college basketball against the Kansas team a year ago.
Amazing. Bolden scores with a foul.
Now, this would help if Beetle Bolden can continue this kind of one-on-one ability to get to the rim, because we know he can make threes. Now, that gives West Virginia a chance.
There's the shot blocker on the bench with his teammates. Three-point play for Bolden. Mountaineers have a two-point lead and a 7-0 run.
I think the size of West Virginia has bothered Lawson today. They can throw Culver and Gordon at him.
Garrett. They get it back from Lightfoot. Shot clock's down to 6. We got West in the air, but West avoided committing the foul. Lawson hustles after the loose ball. Dietrich Lawson, no good. That's against Kansas. Well, we've been talking about these games coming up.
Funny feeling that Cameron Indoor Stadium will be enough of a motivation that shorthanded Duke will win this game tonight.
Just a feeling.
I have that feeling.
Well, there is a difference, game clock, shot clock. So it's not like the Mountaineers can hold for the final shot, but they are content to let the clock wind here. Garrett switches on to Bolden.
Tough matchup.
Bolden got by him, though. Created a little space. The tip up, no good. Culver rips it away, and then Rush the follow. Still plenty of time. Grimes, one on two. Grimes kind of out of control, but scored anyway.
That has to be something.
2 seconds. 1 second. Bolden couldn't get it off. And the musket goes off. That was a ragged end to a rugged and ragged first half. Kansas turned the ball over 13 times. Their season high for any half, just one more than that. 13's as much as they average in a game. Chris is with the Kansas head coach.
Coach, the 13 turnovers, what do you attribute that to? 13.
Yeah, we were awful. They played harder than us defensively, and we were very, very careless. Hopefully we can regroup a little bit. It wasn't their pressure. They were self-inflicted.
Talk to your team about energy. How do you get more out of them at halftime?
Well, I thought, I actually thought we rebounded the ball as well as we rebounded it all year. Probably. So that's a sign of energy, but we can certainly pressure out and do some things to become a little bit more disruptive. But it's not our defense, it's our offense.
Thank you, Coach. Yeah.
And thank you, Chris. As we get ready to send it to studio, a tie game. Number 7 Kansas being challenged here on the road. Adnan in studio, take it away. All right, welcome back to Saturday Showcase presented by 5-Hour Energy. As we get ready to start the second half, we got a tie game. Number 7, Kansas 23, West Virginia 23. Dave Fleming, Fran Fraschilla, Chris Budden, happy to have you back with us here in Morgantown. I thought it was really interesting, Chris, talked to Bill Self going to the locker room. Bill was happy with his energy on the glass. He liked the way, all the ugliness aside for the Jayhawks, he liked the way Kansas rebounded the ball.
Well, he did, because West Virginia is one of the best offensive rebounding teams in the country. Because they have great size inside, and this is a team that averages, they get like one rebound every 3 shots up on the offensive glass. None of that today. Kansas dominated the defensive glass, which is a good sign. Now, as far as other aspects of the game, whole different story. Lots of sloppiness, and West Virginia's in this game.
Yeah, it wasn't quite as pretty from plan to play, brought to you by Northwestern Mutual. They did plan to try to keep West Virginia off the glass. Those are the ugly numbers that you speak of. Nobody made a three. Nobody in the first half.
And that will change in the second half.
Somebody is going to make one.
Yep.
So Bill Self was happy with the rebounding. Chris, what was Bob Huggins happy with?
Sometimes it's hard to tell with him, but he wasn't concerned about the threes. He said, I'd like to make a basket from 2 feet away. He said, we're getting open shots. We're just not knocking them down. I asked him where he thought this team had shown improvement since Tuesday against TCU. He said he was pleased with the effort and the guard play.
I think that is true. They had a lot of looks close in that didn't go down. Lawson, the defense by Culver.
Yeah, Culver and Gordon have done a really good job on Dedrick Lawson today. They haven't really doubled him, but they both have really good size.
Well, Haley just fell down and did not travel.
I like it.
Baseline.
Now, that's a sneaky play. That is a sneaky play. Fall down, keep your dribble. Freeze the Kansas defense.
I bet if we go in the locker room right now on West Virginia's grease board, that play is drawn up with a big fall down marks the spot for Jermaine Haley.
Hey, gotta be good to be lucky and be lucky to be good. And that's good job by Haley of keeping his composure.
Man, here's how I've won 853 games. This is what we're gonna do. Haley, can he keep his feet? Well, he did, but he couldn't keep the ball. Yikes. Garrett, meanwhile, on the attack, and Culver gets called for the foul. Wow, I don't know.
Well, that happened so quickly. Take a look now. Watch Haley. Now, in all seriousness, he keeps his composure, and this is a good basket. Now, at the other end, there did not look like contact. This is a big dude right here. I can't tell from that angle. I can't. He's inside the circle, obviously. Hard to see if he was vertical there.
To me, that's not a foul. Like, Culver gets the call against him. Bob Huggins shakes his head.
It sure looked like a good block, and it looked like it surprised everybody in the arena. But the angle we had was difficult to tell.
What about this angle?
I think that's verticality.
Oh, for sure.
Straight up. So, hey, this is a great crew today.
This is about as good of a crew as you could
get.
Line
yeah.
up.
So I mean, you get this in the national championship game, you're a coach, you're happy.
Culver, nice look into the corner. Bolden, three!
Now, this is what they need. Take care of the ball, make good decisions, and then your better players have got to step up. Vito Bolden has stepped up today.
And I tell you what, I like young Derek Culver. It's not just brute strength. There's a three on this end for Dotson.
You don't want to go under screens with Dotson. He doesn't shoot a ton of threes, but over the course of the season, 40%. And that's not a good sign.
Bolden is limping, so we knew he wasn't feeling well. He got scratched from the starting lineup, was late coming out for the start of the game, missed sort of the layup lines before opening tip. This is something totally different.
Yeah, I would have liked to have seen, he hits the hip right there, you see it. I would have liked to see him go over the top of the screen and force Dotson to attack the basket as opposed to giving up the three, but Dotson can make that shot.
Culver, great position with the spin and the left-hand finish. Not much that Lawson's gonna do against that. Dotson challenges the big man.
Quietly, Dave, this young man's having a great freshman year. Bill Self's had some great freshman point guards, but he's going to be near the top of that list.
Haley got the whistle. I think they are going to call that a shooting foul. He will get two free throws. Jermaine Haley, who got two fouls, played pretty well in the first half when he was in there, but sat out the last 10 minutes or so of the half. Jermaine Haley at the
line. When you watch him play, and I think this is why Bob Huggins has a little comfort level with him, he really does look like he knows what he's doing with the ball. And that's soothing. When you don't have good guard play, you sweat on every pass if you're a coach.
Jermaine makes one of two. He's from Vancouver, British Columbia, although I don't think his basketball emergence had anything to do with either Vince Carter or the immigration policy.
No, but hey, where's Steve Nash from? BC, British Columbia.
Good inspiration. A dad who played in the NFL, Jermaine, chose hoops
Gerald Vick. Off to a real quick start. We didn't hear much from him in the latter stages of the first half. Here's Garrett on the attack. Not shy, even with the rejection a couple possessions ago.
I think he's gaining some confidence in his own offense.
I think so, too.
Yeah.
Harris against Garrett, who gets called for the foul.
Thing about watching Marcus Garrett on tape, and of course I've seen a couple of KU games, I don't know if you know that, is he has an ability to drop both right and left. So you can't shadow him one way like most players. That's how you guard them. He goes equally well to both hands and poses problems for defenders.
I said to Coach Self before the game, I think Fran, by now, he's seen enough of you, could probably come in here and give your pregame talk. Chase Harler hits the three. Bill was open to the idea. Said, don't tell him to come in here.
I'll pass.
So some threes are starting to go down on both sides. There's Grimes. He knocks one down.
Yeah, that's the thing about Grimes, is less hesitation. Great drive, kick out. And can you see in just a little over a half why there's such a comfort level of having Marcus Garrett out there?
Absolutely. Issa Ahmad had it stripped away. Garrett, the guy who comes over the ball. Ahmad tried to get it back, couldn't do it. Marcus Garrett impacts everything they do. Vick, three. Got it.
That's good basketball. That's the easiest basket with Gerald Vick will get all day.
Quick timeout for Bob Huggins. We'll be back after this.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Phillips 66, proud sponsor of Big 12 basketball.
Call Marcus Garrett whatever you want, center fielder, free safety. But one thing he's great at, he knows how to leave his man and help on a teammate's man. Not concerned with Wesley Harris jump shooting, so he's going to muck up the traffic in the lane. And he does that time and time again. He's got not only great instincts and size and athleticism, but there's a basketball IQ that goes all the way back to Mr. Henry Iba. Because as I've mentioned, his high school coach was an assistant at Oklahoma State for Eddie Sutton. His college coach was an assistant for Eddie Sutton. His college coach played at Oklahoma State. And Mr. Iba's defense is in that kid's DNA.
You think we don't know the history of this game? There you go. There's your history lesson for the day. We'll be back. Well, I think it's good news that Beetle Bolden is back out of the locker room on the bench. Here's what's happened a few minutes ago. It almost looked like hip to hip there. Chris, do you have any news on the West Virginia guard?
Well, he came out still kind of walking gingerly after the injury. They went to the side of the court. They looked at it, was hoping maybe they could stretch it out, but he was in a ton of pain. So they took him back to the locker room where he was not able to really walk under his own power. He did when he came back out here, though.
He still, to me, thank you, Chris, looked like when he sat down, there was still a lot of discomfort. So we'll see. I mean, if you're going to play, this would be a game where you would just sort of say, I'm getting back in there.
No question about it. And he's always been a guy that, especially in big moments, of course, he had the luxury of playing with two great guards, and Carter and Miles, and was a great third banana.
He's also been such a good second-half player of late for the Mountaineers, who still struggled to make free throws. Culver missed both of those. Lawson trying to go by him. Culver quick enough to stay with him, but then committed the foul.
Culver's getting an education in this brief period of time in the Big 12. One of the things he's got to learn to do, and he's got such great potential to be a dominant player in this league, is he's got to just keep his hands straight up and not come down on the shooter. And if a guy makes a shot over you, you tip your hat, you go back the other end. All big kids who come to college have a real problem with verticality. They're so used to trying to block shots in high school. And to be honest, Dave, there aren't that many guys who can score over length in college. Sometimes if you give up a basket, it's better than giving up a cheap foul that forces you and your coach to have to sit down on the bench.
Chris?
Well, Derek Culver didn't know if he was going to play football or basketball for a while. He didn't have a lot of faith that he could have a future in basketball. He
shot hits the three. It wasn't until Bob Huggins came down and recruited him, and he told me that Huggins had more faith in him than he had in himself, which is why he chose to come to West Virginia, the loyalty that Huggins showed him.
Yeah, I think he is going to be a real good one. That's a turnover for the Jayhawks, and Vito Bolden comes back in the game.
That's a good sign for Bob Huggins. They've kind of managed to stay close, and if Vito Bolden can give them a little bit more offensive firepower, that'll really help them.
With Culver on the bench with three fouls, Andrew Gordon, a redshirt sophomore, former football player himself, is in the game. He started today, has had some moments.
He has. He made that first move of the game that I thought was a quick move and almost got lost in a cheap foul.
Bolden, three, off the mark. Kansas continues to do a good job on the defensive glass. Austin just never gave it up and then lost it out of bounds. Well, don't miss our first UFC Fight Night card presented by Modelo, live from Friends Neighborhood, Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York. Promises to be a heck of a night. Main event at 10 Eastern on ESPN+. Prelims, of course, before that on ESPN.
Yeah, that's going to be a great night in downtown Brooklyn, a place where Kansas played earlier in the year in the preseason NIT.
They did. Out of bounds. Harris had it and just lost it.
They beat a very good Tennessee team in overtime. Beat Marquette, where they trailed double figures at the half.
Tell you what, come seeding time, tournament time, neutral court win against Tennessee is going to be one of the best wins of any team in the country this year.
Agreed. And Kansas plays, I haven't seen the analytics this week. They may play the toughest non-conference schedule in the country. And they're not being rewarded right now on the net, the new NCAA system. But that's because they're still working the kinks out, the NCAA.
Ahmad, another three. Good!
The longer this game goes, the more the crowd will get it going. And it's going to be interesting for Kansas.
They call a foul against Gordon. Well, this guy, Issa Ahmad, no stranger to big games against Kansas in this building.
Well, he's no stranger to big games, and he's also no stranger to going into witness protection, because he's had a 27-point night against Kansas, another 20-point game, but five times versus Kansas in his career, he's had games of 6 points or less. So I think Bob Huggins would take the guy that got 27 on them in that last win 2 years ago.
Cut in the passing lane, deflected it, but it stays Kansas ball. Dotson found his fellow freshman, and Grimes hits the three.
Big sign, too. That's good for Grimes. No hesitation. Catch and shoot, drive and kick. These two freshmen are playing as many minutes as a freshman backcourt in about 12, 13 years. You got to go back to Chalmers and Rush to have the kind of pressure put on a freshman backcourt playing for Bill Self.
Pretty good combo that was.
Yes, it was.
They've had 16 lead changes. Now a whistle away from the ball against Kansas.
There's that speed by Dotson under control. Avoids the charge. Great catch and shoot right there by Grimes. You know, when you talk about Kansas and the great point guards, oh, there's an inside opportunity.
Nice out-of-bounds play. Gets Haley to the free throw line.
Yeah, you think about what these two freshman guards are doing this year. You go back through the years, and whether it's Tyshawn Taylor, Sherron Collins, you know, Devontae Graham, Frank Mason, there's always been a guy to kind of lead them the way in the backcourt. These two guys don't have anybody to lean on with the experience of handling the ball so much. Some of the great guards under Bill Self have had.
Haley, one more free throw to try to tie the game again. 16 lead changes. And now a tie, 42-42, with over 12 minutes to go. Garrett, and that was going to go down anyway, I think. Gordon gets called for the goaltending.
I think the way you got to guard this guy, the way he's driving, is I just think you got to just dare him to shoot threes. He made three in a row against Texas, but you can't let him get to the basket this easy. Too good a driver.
Here's a three, in and out, no good. Awesome, good outlet, and here comes Dotson with his speed. Garrett's pass a little too high. I think K.J. Lawson was looking for a lob.
Yeah, and that's one of those turnovers where that's unselfishness.
Yeah, I think Kansas can live with that one.
Not too many of them.
They've had way too many overall in this game, that's for sure. Down low, Harris. Double team. Garrett strips it away, but his foot was out of bounds. So he's got five steals, almost six. He's been the best defensive player on the court. He and the Jayhawks with a slim two-point lead. Well, rightfully so, we're talking a lot about Marcus Garrett's defense, but it's not all defense with this guy.
No, it's just something that he's adding to his game. You know, he's a starter now over the last 10 or so games, and you can tell why. He's like a security blanket for this Kansas team right now. The defense is a given. And, you know, it's interesting as his numbers go up offensively, when you watch him play and practice in games, Kansas really doesn't have a team leader. Dedrick Lawson is one of the best players in college basketball, but not vocal. I think Garrett's last two seasons, he is going to be one of those guys. Let's put it this way. Senior night for him 3 years from now is going to be very emotional because I think he's going to leave as one of the most popular Jayhawks ever because of how Bill Self feels about him.
Yeah, I think you're right. Bolden off the inbound play, got challenged, and it went off the side of the backboard. Kansas ball leading by two, under 12 to play. Here comes Marcus Garrett again. He'll get back to the free throw line.
Now, he wasn't doing this early in the year.
No.
You know, he was making a simple play. This is what happens when you watch a player grow up before your eyes. He's well coached every single day in practice. He does things that help your team win. And then as he gains more confidence, he realizes, you know what, I'm pretty damn good.
Well, you have to be well coached if your lineage goes back to Henry Iba, which his does.
It does.
His high school coach and his high school coach's connection to the history of that program in Stillwater and Eddie Sutton.
And his college coach.
Yeah. Bill Self, of course, who is from that great basketball tree.
Yep.
It's a big tree.
Big tree.
Almost a turnover. Bolden kept it from going to the backcourt. Shot clock all the way down to seven. Does Gordon know it? He's going to muscle his way in. Had it stripped away by Lawson. KJ Lawson. His brother down low, Dietrich. Got a great look and finishes.
He's so good down there. He really reads his own man defensively, and he can spin both ways.
I think you can sense a little nervousness out inside this Coliseum. Kansas, a couple buckets in a row, is up the lead to five.
Good defense. Great on-ball defense.
Somehow Bolden didn't travel a mod. Had a great look for three. Lawson has been all over the defensive glass.
Watch Dietrich. He's actually more comfortable on the other block, but that's just relative because he knows what he's doing inside. He can go other side of the rim. He can go middle. He's been, let's face it, one of the best players in college basketball in the first half of the year.
He has been. Mr. Double-Double. It's not just stats. Culver back in the game with his three fouls. Gordon gave him some minutes off the bench, but now Derek Culver back in. KJ into the corner. Grimes, high up off the backboard, got challenged. And it's going to be West Virginia ball. Well, SportsCenter, there will be a lot to talk about tonight. Won't there be with Zubin and Michael? Getting ready, I'm sure, already with all the NFL stuff queued up for tomorrow, the UFC stuff, the NBA, Virginia Duke, our college hoops here in Morgantown, the game earlier in Madison, Wisconsin, Michigan, number two, undefeated, goes down. That's all on SportsCenter. Holden has had a hard time staying on his feet. Ooh. He kept the dribble alive.
Pete Kimmel said he bobbled it.
Harris, Culver offensive rebound with a foul.
He's a man.
West Virginia needed that bad.
Yeah, he's a man. When you make Dedrick Lawson look small, you're a big guy. Watch this now. They've done a good job of containing him today, but watch him come out of nowhere, and he just powers his way through. He's about 6'10", 250. Sometimes those heights are inflated, but when you stand next to him, I know you mentioned that this morning.
Yeah, he looms large. And you can see the football background, too, just sort of the aggressive nature of Derek Culver. Maybe finally grew out of football a little bit, although you sort of dream about what would a 6'10 tight end with that physique look like on the football field. Three-point play. Back to a two-point lead for Kansas.
Kansas City Chiefs had a 6'10 tight end back when they were playing in the old AFL. Stroud, maybe. Somebody will tweet me.
They always do, friend.
Oh, yeah, they always do.
Wow, Grimes way off. They're going to call Ahmad, though, for a push-off. The look sort of says it all. They channel their coach here.
He's a beloved figure, nominated to the Basketball Hall of Fame. Oh, that's in play.
That was, what a break for West Virginia. That was going out of bounds. Tipped in. Good hustle by Haley. Well, Keith Kimble didn't mean for that to happen, but West Virginia took advantage. Here's Dotson right to the bucket.
Who was that? That was McCormick sealed off the help side defense just by posting up so Culver couldn't get there.
A subtle play that helped create the lane for his teammate.
This is a game that feels like Kansas is up 5 or 6. Well, they're playing with a little bit of fire right now.
Harris gets double teamed and went right through it.
Well, Garrett and Lawson aren't going to be out long.
In the corner, Vic hits the three.
The peaks and valleys of Vic's shooting this year has been unbelievable. That stretch in December, where he made 28 of 43, he's on a similar stretch the last three games.
Yeah, he came in red hot. Has hit 2 of 4 from behind the line in this game. Ahmad, that double team tried to come. Really turned into a triple team, and then Culver made a nice cut. He'll go to the free throw line. Now, these are the numbers that Fran was just talking about. First 6 games, red hot. Next 9, couldn't buy a bucket. Last 2, and now into today, he is knocking down shots again. And it makes Kansas a different team.
Yeah, now he's only shooting about 49% from behind the arc.
Peaks and valleys.
Pretty good. That's a big peak. 49%.
Well, I kind of like the sound of that, Ed, man.
Yeah. Interesting.
That would be a big story. Tennessee's got an argument for that number one spot that you figure is up for grabs with Duke going down earlier this week against an unranked Syracuse team, although a very capable Syracuse team. Out of this timeout, Culver back at the line. The big man is starting to get his touch at the free throw line.
Now you can tell for a guy that's played limited games so far how much raw potential he has. They have a top 25 big man that'll be a bookend with this guy, Oscar Tshiebwe. From the same high school that produced Saj Kanate. I think Kanate, my gut feeling is he'll be off to the NBA next year. I don't know that, but I don't think Bob Huggins is worried as much about that because of the size he's got coming in.
Can you imagine if Kanate somehow, whether it's because of injury, needed another year, came back? Lawson scores under the basket against Culver. It'll be 3 pretty talented big men.
Exactly.
For West Virginia.
And then Gordon as well, only a sophomore.
Culver almost had it ripped away. That's hard to do against him. Ahmad couldn't finish.
Oh, man, point-blank range.
Got to make those.
Yep.
Great pass from Culver. I've been impressed with his vision. He's made a few good passes. Guess who's back in the game?
Dedrick Lawson.
And Marcus Garrett, who just got a couple-minute breather on the bench.
foul against the Mountaineers. This one against Lamont West. Send the freshman Dotson to the free throw line.
First time I saw Dotson, I was running the Under Armour All-American camp in Charlotte. He was playing for Jeff McGinnis, former North Carolina star NBA player, and that's when Kansas really put him on their radar going into his junior year. Even back then, there's a poise about him. It's almost like you don't notice he's out there. Now, today, the turnovers are not going to make Bill Self happy, but to throw a freshman into the first game of the season against Michigan State and have him play with the poise he has is pretty good.
Worked with Jeff McGinnis, worked with Muggsy Bogues in the Charlotte area as a young player. Ahmad gets another touch. This time the jumper is good. He missed the layup, but he hits that one.
Exactly. Still hanging around.
Very much so.
Yep. Kansas is going to have to be very efficient this last 6 minutes.
The number two team in the country went down on the road to start our Saturday. The number seven team in the country being challenged on the road here. Lawson gets it back, had it blocked, but a foul. And I think they're calling Culver, who cannot believe it.
That's a bad break for West Virginia because Culver did a really good job defensively the entire way. Lawson put up a tough shot, but he stayed with it. Bob Huggins is looking up at that scoreboard. Watch, this is good defense. And then they don't come up with that second opportunity, and Lawson does.
Yeah, the whistle came just a moment after that picture went away. So Culver, four fouls, will go to the bench, presumably for at least a couple minutes. And West Virginia goes much smaller. Harris replaces him, not Andrew Gordon. Lawson made them both. He's a good free throw shooter. Harris shoots a rare three. That's why they're rare.
Yep. He's improved in that area, but in small sample sizes. There's a reason he was open.
Dotson, that quickness. Found Garrett, three, no good.
Now, if you're West Virginia, you don't want Kansas to get up six, seven, or eight. Not with this much time remaining. And they've got to be really efficient every possession.
West got the contact, the bucket, and will go to the free throw line. I wasn't so sure when he started that move.
No, I agree, but he used his body well. Good body control. Watch him take his body right to Garrett, who can't get legal. So Garrett does a smart thing and throws his hands up. And good finish by Lamont West.
That's big news for Kansas, because isn't that the fourth personal against Marcus Garrett? We've had a lot of different ways to describe what he means to this Kansas team. All the depth, all the talent, all the high school All-Americans. They are a different team when he's sitting right there.
There's no question. And the flip side for West Virginia, now we're in a situation where they've been in four of the five games they've lost. Can they close the door on Kansas?
They say jump ball, jump ball. Not a block shot. And the arrow favors the Mountaineers.
Wow. Here's the drive right here.
What do you think?
I thought he followed through and went off of Dotson. And it's not reviewable until the final 2 minutes.
Either way, West Virginia ball. Here's West, three. Ahmad couldn't get the offensive rebound. Jayhawks on the move.
Another defensive rebound by Dedrick Lawson.
He's had a lot of those.
Yes, he has.
Dotson missed the layup.
I would push it right here. Well, they got everybody back.
West Virginia has not been able to get out and get some easy baskets.
No.
Harris wants to try another one.
I just don't think that's the shot you want. One thing I really like about Von Dotson is, he uses his speed really well.
He does.
Not just in the full court, but in the half court. If he doesn't turn the corner, he spins it back out and keeps the offense alive.
Uses that little hook move and scores.
You've seen the whole arsenal today, the toolbox.
13 and 10 for Dedrick Lawson. Another double-double for him. It's a four-point lead for Kansas.
48th in his career.
Yeah, that's a big number considering he played 2.5 years. Bolden, they need Beetle Bolden.
Oh, no.
Flipped one up.
That had no chance.
No chance.
Not at all. He would have been better off shooting that contested three out at the top of the key. Let's see what Kansas does now to control the tempo down the stretch with a four-point lead.
A.J. Lawson. Now can they get a transition basket? Bolden, three. Way too strong. But he got fouled. He got fouled by Quentin Grimes. That's a big mistake. And that means three free throws, a chance for West Virginia to make this a one-point game.
Yeah, oh yeah. We're still a few weeks away, Adnan. Give me a few more weeks.
3:22 to go, 60-56. Alongside Fran Fraschilla, Chris Budden here from Morgantown. Beetle Bolden out of this timeout, got fouled, shooting a three. He's got three free throws coming to try to make this a one-point game. He's not going to make it a one-point game. This does not happen very often. By this, a Kansas team that is as good as they typically are, losing to a team that's 0-5 or worse in Big 12 play. And West Virginia, it's hard to believe, but they are 0-5. And that was well played.
That was a historic night down in Fort Worth, and of course, at that press conference.
Bill Self had kind of a famous line, didn't he?
Yep, he said, we couldn't even beat Topeka YMCA tonight.
So it's a two-point lead for the Jayhawks. Chris?
Well, Bill Self reminding his team during that timeout that they still have three timeouts remaining. And if you get into trouble offensively, call that timeout. When he talked to me before the game, he said, late in games, I have to be a better teacher. I have to remind my guys that they're young. They don't know everything. So he was really going through more simplistic things during that timeout.
What a move by Dedrick Lawson.
I'm a little surprised they haven't double-teamed him, honestly, because one-on-one, you're not going to stop him. So then it puts the pressure on your offense to score every time down. Because Phil Self's no, he's been doing this a little while. He's going to keep going into Lawson.
They called him out for the foul.
Yep, swim move.
Well, that's going to be a West Virginia turnover. He and Marcus Garrett got tangled up. It would have been Garrett's fifth if they'd called it on him. It's Ahmad who gets called for the personal.
Take a look now. Watch Issa Ahmad. You just can't extend that left arm this year. They're not going to let you do that. Point of emphasis. Now, Culver's going to guard Lawson. Phil Self will likely go back inside. He knows Culver's got four. And I just don't think you can guard Dedrick Lawson. Watch this.
He set the screen. Garrett took it right at Culver.
That's great. If Garrett didn't go all the way, Lawson has the lob. That's become equally effective for both of those guys at one play.
Every possession huge now for the Mountaineers. Bob Huggins wants to talk it over. He'll use one of his two remaining timeouts. With 2:23 to go, still very much in doubt. Six-point lead for the seventh-ranked Jayhawks. When we are done here, we got two more great college hoops games for you. Coming up next, Kentucky and Auburn. We saw Dickie V getting ready for that one. That's at 4 Eastern, just a few minutes away. Kentucky playing, I think, much better lately. Is that fair to say? And then
yes.
Our Sonic blockbuster, Virginia and Duke, top five matchup at Cameron Indoor.
Yeah, going to be an incredible matchup. No Trey Jones. I just have a sneaky feeling that Duke's going to just rally, see some superhuman efforts maybe out of R.J. Barrett and Reddish and Big Zion.
Well,
Well, by the way, speaking of that Virginia Duke game, our Sonic Blockbuster game, player ISO cam, I think this is pretty cool, on ESPN Plus. It's like an extra viewing experience focusing on individual players. You can get it through the ESPN app. Reese, Seth, and Jay are also going to have our first ever ESPN Plus multicast, sort of like a mega cast for that game. So check those out. The three is good from Wesley Harris. You said he'd worked on it. That's a big one.
Well, he shoots 38% wide open. You don't mind that shot. He's taken a couple of challenge ones, I thought. But now you got to deal with Lawson inside if you're West Virginia.
Garrett, nifty little ball handling, but then bricked the shot. Under 2 minutes to go.
I just think you got to keep the ball and the defense moving right now.
I got knocked down. West Virginia wanted the fifth foul against Marcus Garrett. It didn't come. Bolden challenged. Good feed. Culver makes his move and scores.
Great move. Great patience inside.
Now it's going to get loud. Bill Self called the timeout. Little 5-0 run for the Mountaineers.
Yep, and they have hung around all game long. This is a terrific. There's the open three by Wesley Harris, the junior from Jackson, Mississippi, who has improved his outside shooting. And then I love to watch this post move. Little Hezzy inside.
Can you believe this is the same West Virginia team that you watched in Fort Worth just a few days ago?
You know, I can, because the previous four games they lost, they were in every game. And then you just expect them to come home. It's conference play. And they've had success here. And I've seen a little bit more pride today wearing that WVU jersey than I saw on Tuesday night.
Shot clock already down to 11. Garrett on the attack. Missed it. And then got it back with the steal.
Oh, man. How about
Garrett? What a play.
Well, Garrett had the guts to drive it and try to score. And then he had the IQ to come right back and steal it.
There's no way Culver knew where he was. He came out of nowhere. Now Bill Self's going to call another timeout. How many of those kind of plays have we seen in this game from Marcus Garrett, this game, this year?
And with all due respect to his Hall of Fame coach, this is a play that's, you don't teach this here. This is pure basketball instinct from growing up and playing every day of your life as a young kid. There's the drive, and watch. Culver just doesn't have the experience to understand where Garrett is on the floor, and he does what he's been doing, at least Jayhawks, all season long.
You saw the graphic, and I think it undersold. He's got 6 steals now, Marcus Garrett does. That is a career high. 15 points, efficient from the field, 3 assists. He's done more defensively than just the steals, but 6 steals, big number.
No, it really, it's hard to equate him. You know, look at this now. It's not on his man. It's usually on somebody else's man. And that's because he has great instincts away from the basketball.
All right, back to action. There is a difference. Shot clock, game clock. 1-point lead for Kansas with the ball.
Now, Beto Bolden's doing a great job of keeping Grimes from getting it.
Vic against Harris. Shot clock at 3. Challenged. Air ball. And here come the Mountaineers. Shot clock is off.
One timeout.
Ahmad fighting for position down low. Culver wants some help. 10 seconds to go. Haley all the way. Haley scores!
Bulls lead 8.5. Vic almost loses it. The heave, no good. The follow, no good. Two games so far on this Saturday, two top 10 teams, two court stormings. What a bounce back performance for West Virginia. And now they get to sing. I don't think many people thought we'd be hearing this song.
Well, there's a lot of fun stuff around college basketball. There's not much more fun than hearing Country Roads in the West Virginia University Coliseum.
That's the shot from Jermaine Haley that put the Mountaineers ahead plenty of time. 8 seconds.
Yep, and Bill Self did not want a timeout. He told his team, push it up the floor before the defense could get set, and they just didn't get the look that they probably needed.
Chris is with one of the heroes, Beto Bolden.
Beto, given where this team was 5 days ago, a tough loss on the road to TCU, how did you knock off Kansas today?
Coach just told us to come out with a lot of energy, and I think we did. We played them terrific in our defensive end. We got key rebounds, we got key stops, and Jermaine made a huge play at the end for us, which got us over top. I love it.
You alone got sick before the game. You had to leave because of a hip injury. How did you tough this one out?
I'm a warrior. That's what I do. I fight the pain. I'm here for my teammates no matter what, and I'm gonna go out there and go to war with it.
Congratulations. Go sing.
Thank you.
They're still singing.
They'll be singing and partying all night long in Morgantown. I can tell you that.
I know we got to go to our next game, but don't you want to just kick back and listen a little more? I think we can hear a few more notes, can't we? Here's why they're singing. Their first conference win. The Country Roads, the celebration for Chris, for Fran, Dave Fleming saying so long. Mountaineers get it done. Kentucky Auburn, time for that one.